Hello everyone, welcome back once again. In this video we will look at custom dynamic user control with event handlers. Also when it is clicked. How to get its values or properties in C# Windows Forms. So, let's get started. First, add a user control. There are two ways you can add user control in Visual Studio. Click Project and select Add User Control. Or, right-click Project Name in Solution Explorer. Select Add, and then User Control. Next, design a user control. Here I have picture box with size mode set to zoom. And a panel with yellow background color. A label for a title. And another label for subtitle. I have also used a panel to show shadow under a user control. Right-click on user control and select view code. Here I have getter and setter. To get and set the values to labels and picture box. I have also added mouse enter and leave events to generate hover effect on user control. Now add flow layout panel to main form. After adding flow layout panel, right-click on the form and select view code. In generate dynamic user controlled function. First we have to clear flow layout panel. Just ink as if flow layout panel has previous user controls. Here I have created array of user control type. Named as list items to keep every dynamic user control object. I have set list items size to 5 because I want to create 5 different dynamic user controls. For this video, I have used static data. For title, subtitle and icons that stored in arrays. Icons are in the resources folder in Solution Explorer. This for loop runs 5 times because I have set list items size to 5. Inside a loop, a new user control object is being initialized and stored in the list items array. Then set icon, title, and subtitle to the newly created user control. Once the user control is created and the value stored. Now, adding the user control to flow layout panel. After adding user control to flow layout panel, now let's add click event for this. To get generate dynamic user control function working. Call it in form load event of the main form. Now let's code to perform function for the user control click event. This event will perform function when user control be clicked. In this click event I have created user control object. To access icon, title, and subtitle. This is why we created getter and setter in the user control class. Next, add panel to main form. and inside this panel, add picture box. Label for title, subtitle, and a button. After adding panel to main form. Now, let's get icon, title, and subtitle from a selected user controlled and set them to picture box and labels in a panel. Inside a dynamic user control, click event. Use object to get values and set to picture box and labels in a panel. After this, I have set a panel visible property to true to visible a panel so that the values should be visible when a user control is clicked. To set panel visible property, I have used two functions, show panel and hide panel. At last, I have called hide panel function and OK button click event. So, I hope you liked the video. Tell me in the comments if you want to watch handling dynamic user controls with database. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.